Hello everybody and welcome to this video on computer science video. And in this video we'll learn how to draw shapes using the script loops. So without much talk, let's begin. See, most of you would have tried to draw figures of this kind, triangles, outline figures, diamonds, hourglass figures as part of your and syllables and parts of it is watch this video very carefully, and we'll be trying an entirely new way of drawing these figures, and once you understand this you never have any problems ever again in doing these figures. That much you can guarantee. So let's move ahead. This is a square figure, 7x7 figure, and this will be our basis for drawing all these figures. All of these figures extended can be made into a square, and we'll have to cut out some parts of it to get this figure. So first of all we'll try and implement this, and by cutting out parts from this figure we'll try and implement all of the figures that is on the previous page. Start with hand equal to 7, and we change it back from there. For row equal to row in range, going to in this one. Line doesn't change, and then print. Right, print the statement so that the line actually changes. So this is what we need. Oops, over to Randy again. Buttons. This is quite curious, and the seven figure. Now we'll try and make every figure that we saw on the previous page move from this basic figure by just cutting out parts from it. So let us try to make this first of all a diagonal line, a leading diagonal line. Now, observe those numbers very carefully. See, this is 7, 1, 6, 1, 7, 2. 6 minus 1 is 5, 7 minus 2 is 5. 5 minus 1 is 4, 6 minus 2 is 4, 7 minus 3 is 4. Quite clearly, when you move along the diagonal in this direction, the row minus column value is always the same. Just in case you're wondering, the first value here is the row and the second one is the column. And they remain the same for each and every line. You check it out. And for the leading diagonal, the middle diagonal, it's always the same. Row and column is same for this. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. You can define it either as row equal to column, or you can define it as row minus column equal to 0. And for this part, row is less than column, and for this part, row is greater than column. Let's see how we can use this. I'll create a variable called condition. Is equal to row equal to column, and make this O a conditional statement. If condition, then we print O else See, basically this condition is allowing us to cut out parts from the figure. So in this case, only the parts which satisfy the condition will print O, and the rest will be space. Essentially, that will be cut out. What happens now was this. See. The rest of the figure has been cut out, and we have got the leading diagonal moving. Okay. See, check this way. In this case, we are moving across this direction. 2 plus 1. 3, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 2 plus 2, 4, 1 plus 3, 4. Along this direction, if we move from down to up like this, the row number decreases and the column number increases every time. So row plus column is always the same for every line we're going in this direction. And for the middle line, it's 7 plus 1, 6 plus 2. Please remember the n for our case is 7. So all this is always n plus 1. Hence the condition is row plus column is equal to n plus 1. Can we use this? Row plus column is equal to n plus 1. That is n. See, got this. The diagonal angle, the non-leading diagonal to be precise. What if you want to combine both of them? You can use the for condition. All will work as a union over here, and will work as a intersection. So rho equal to cosinus. For both the diagonals. What difference if I put and? We'll only get the part that is common to both of them. That is this. Okay. So for our case, we need it all. The lower half of the figure, we can call this a lower triangle. Now, what are the conditions for this? See, for all this part, rho is greater than column, and for this, rho is greater than equal to column. So we can combine this and say rho greater than equal to column. This will be the right here. Condition equal to rho greater than equal to column. It's that easy. All you need to do is to just change the condition and pick the proper elements. What if I wanted just the outline and all along here? See. For this line, as you can see, column is always equal. This line, obviously, rho is equal to 7, which is the same as m. So, or rho equal to m. And now we need a diagonal to correct from here. I know it already. Or rho is equal to. The outline figure. screen. What if you want the other side? One simple way is just do the less communication. Now you can shift between this just by putting a knot over here. What's this? If you want an outline figure from this, then this is really good to you. This figure. For this figure, we need to cut out this part. So, what are the conditions here? See, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4, 2 plus 2 is 4, 1 plus 3 is 4, 7 plus 1 is 6 plus 2 is 8, 5 plus 3 is 8. So, essentially, this part. For this part, row plus column is less than equal to n plus 1. So row plus column is less than equal to n plus 1. Okay. And for the other part, obviously, it will be greater than equal to. Or simply putting a knot over here, you've done it anyway. So, and if you want the outline, I'm sure you can do it by yourself. Anyway, let's have a try. This is on this part. Move this door. This is row equal to 1. Row equal to 1. Or row plus column is equal to 1. Let's see what we've got next. I'm going to make this one. An outline square figure. So basically, we need to cut the inner parts out. This is too easy. Thank you. I want the diagonal as well. Now, if I want to write a Z, how do you write Z? This line, and this line. So, if you want a Z, you can simply cut out the rest of the lines. Cut out the column 31. Then, cut out the column 31. Two rows of this video. What else? Z. This line has to go. So cut out the row quickly. Z. What happens if you want the M? See, just by changing the conditions over here, you can create any figure that you want. It's that simple. Like that. Just look at the lines as usual. This is 4 plus 1, 5. 3 plus 2, 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 1 plus 4, 5. So we are getting 5 here. And this is what? This is 4. So this is the middle point in a 7-sided square. So basically, in these calculations with the minus with the midpoint. First thing is create a variable called row plus call is equal to mid plus I'll come to the next part. Let's say this one. This is row and this is call. For this, as you can see, row minus column is always equal to 3. Okay. Row minus column equal to 3 means row minus column is equal to or let's say column minus row is equal to mid minus 1. So, or column minus row This one is row minus column equal to mid minus 1. In every case, it is 3. Row minus column is equal to mid minus 1. Row plus column is 7 plus 4, 11, 6 plus 5, 11, 5 plus 6, 11. What is 11? This is the n, this is 7, and this is mid. So row plus column is equal to n plus mid. Now, will this work for other figures where n is not 7? Let's see if I use this 5. See, everything is dependent on n, and therefore, as we change n, it will still work. I have not used any magic number. I have never used 7 or 11 or any number, all based on row, mid, and n and all, so it will work. Yes, what happens if you use even numbers? Well, it won't work. Okay. So you always need some even numbers have to be avoided. Okay. You want to fifth time. See, we started this one. Row plus column is equal to mid plus 1. Okay. Now, what if I put this greater than equal to mid plus 1? See, it will select this part and this part. The whole figure will be selected. Let us try. Row plus column greater than equal to mid plus 1. Okay. From here we've got all this here. Now, we need to cut out from beyond this. Okay. So row plus column has also got to be less than equal to n plus mid. And so while drawing the outline diamond, I remember we are doing intersection over here, so it will be and row plus column is less than equal to now we need to cut out this part and this part. Intersection does it. See, for this, four minus one, five minus two, six minus three. So row minus column is less than equal to mid minus one. It combines. And column minus row is also equal to mid minus 1. We got all things. We need only the upper half.
How do you do it?
Basically, we need to cut out this part.
What's the condition for that?
Rho is greater than mid.
And so we combine where rho is less than mid. Rho is less than mid. Okay. For this point.
Greater than the mid will be in the
middle part.
Now we try and do. So to print an error, the first thing is printing the middle. Clearly this is rho equal to mid. Now for this one. One plus four, 5, 2 plus 5. 1 minus 4 is 3, 2 minus 5 is 4 minus 1 is 3, 5 minus 2 is 3, 6 minus 3 is 3, 7 minus 4 is 3, which means column minus row is equal to mid minus 1. Or column minus row. Previous time we've seen this time before. Row plus column is equal to n plus 1. Row plus column is equal to n plus 1. Okay. All in this video here, as we have seen, we can draw as many figures as we want and just by changing this condition, nothing else had to be changed. We just made a full figure and kept on changing from that. Just cutting out parts of the figure, we reached